warm West Wakefield. Welcome. Welcome, everybody. It's great to be back. So Fiona and I met at my camp. I do a gypsy jazz camp in Holland. She came over from Paris, and we actually played one tune together. And we enjoyed it so much that we have a show upcoming in December in Rotterdam in Concert Hall. So this is actually our real premiere.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So we both met through Gypsy Jazz, but actually Fiona has, just like myself, this massive, serious classical background. And also, she's half Irish, so much more than me, she has a claim to playing the kind of Celtic side of things. I can claim it through my mother too, but she's kind of a little bit Scottish, that doesn't really count. Anyway, we started out with a tune called Coquette, a very old vaudeville tune from the 20s, American tune, with a French title actually. Fiona's the only one who understands what Coquette is, so I don't know. And we, of course, followed that by the famous tune I Got Rhythm by Mr. and Mrs. Gershwin, Who wrote the next tune, do you know?
I don't.
No, neither do I. Somebody wrote this famous tune, a lot of people play it, and every time Fiona plays it, it reminds her of a cough she had in 1937. See? Sounds like 1937. It's called Blue Bossa. Thank you. Yes. Okay, so here's a game we are going to play. It's also a premiere. The game is you give us some ideas and we improvise on the ideas. So the idea could be an image, a sentence, or a country, or whatever, season. You know, I'm giving you too many ideas already. So ideas, please. Maybe
Celtic.
Three.
Celtic.
Okay, we'll shelve that one. That's going to happen. It's going to happen. Balkan, okay. What's that?
Waterfall.
Waterfall, I like that. Okay. Let's start with the waterfall. Any countries that you would be happy to visit somewhere?
Italy.
Spain.
Good. You were Spain. They're all foreign countries. What's wrong with you people? Somebody wants to go to Norway or something?
Sweden.
Okay. We'll try and sort of do something with our creative side of our brain, which is either left or right, I can't remember. But let's do the waterfall thing first.
Thank you.
After the break. Japan and Thailand after the break. I think we should play your Django Reinhardt tune. Would you mind? It's actually a very beautiful, beautiful ballad. It's the Mind's Journal of 1937 track, Cough. It's called Tears.
Thank you.
really a break, all of us, because it's getting hot and dense in here. So I've heard that, like previous times, there are some wonderful watermelons outside waiting for us. You know, 1 million flies, can't be wrong. And so we would like to play our final tune of this first set, and then there'll be a second set with loads of flies. There's a very exciting thing that happened last year when I was not here. Yes, exciting things do happen outside West Wakey. I recorded a duet album for the first time. The first time I recorded this kind of line. Not with Fiona, because we hadn't met at that stage. But with a wonderful guitarist called Sam Notich. And lo and behold, it will be for sale right there when you walk out. So go and have a look at that. I can highly recommend it. It's got some wonderful reviews, and it's just bloody nice. Without further ado, oh, and put your email on that list if you're not on there, so for next time you hear what's happening. We are going to play, I think, the very first official jazz tune from the time that jazz was spelt with two Z's instead of, or Z's, you say in this country, instead of an S. Jazz was a two S's thing before. And this was kind of arranged and composed by somebody who's been lost in the midst of time, and a guy called Nick LaRocca, who had his own band, he kind of claimed the tune. So I'm going to say it's Tiger Rag by Nick LaRocca, but actually it's not him who wrote it. So actually it's Tiger Rag by somebody else. How sad is that? We will do this in arrangement by Stefan Grappelli. Are you ready? Yes, are you ready?
Yes.
Just check.
Thank you.
Thank you.
started this second set out with a tune written by, I think, Jalmar Ferreira, and I'm guessing this guy was from Brazil, because it was a bossa nova. So I'm guessing it's maybe Rio de Janeiro, where he came from. Well, I guess.
That's a big country.
With a high probability rate, actually. And he wrote this tune called Bossa Recado, which is the gift. So, there you go, that was for you. And then that was followed by a co-composition by Django Reinhardt and Johann Sebastian Bach. Called Django, Prelude and Fugue. We've both a great love for one guy who, in Fiona's case, inspired her teacher to start playing, and through her teacher she got into the music. And in my case, inspired me directly through his CD, actually. I got to meet him in 1995, just 2 years before he died, and his name was Stefan Capelli, and he was without doubt the biggest name in the jazz violin history. Also, a really, really nice man. He was very supportive. And I played for him, I just started playing, and so it was actually pretty bad. But I was throwing my youthful enthusiasm into it, and he saw something, so he was very supportive, he says, keep doing this. But one thing he said I never forgot, which was, it's great to play my music, but you should play your own music. So just take whatever you like, and don't worry whether it's jazz or classical or folk. He said, I've never worried about that. And actually, he didn't. He worked with Yehudi Menuhin from the classical side. He worked with Ravi Shankar from India. He worked with my friend Frankie Gavin from Ireland. He did all kinds of things. He just said, he worked with Basil Clemens from the States, actually. So he was very eclectic in his taste. And so actually, he's very much inspired to become the musician I've become. So we would like to do a little, and the same goes for Fiona. She's doing exactly. When did we find each other? Last year somewhere. I mean, what are the chances of the same background? I mean, of course, Fiona is 12 years old and I'm 65, but... So, we would like to dedicate this next tune to Stefan Capelli. It's a Stefan Capelli original from an old French movie from the 70s. It's called Les Valseurs, The Waltzers. Thank you. that now. So, that was some Irish stuff. We actually have one tune left if you're up for it, you know, if you can. It's actually a really fun tune. It was composed by Sonny Rollins. It's called Pent Up House. Right from, they call it Pent Up House. And it's actually a sort of bebop standard, I would say. It's reasonably fast. That's why I was slightly hesitant about playing it. Who cares? We're here now anyway. You're here now as well. So you might as well. But before we play this tune, I'd like to thank Paul once again for putting such a wonderful music. Look at the names that are on the bloody program this year. It's incredible. So thank you very much for bringing such wonderful joy and and then yesterday, the day before, a very wide-eyed girl from Paris flew in with jet lag and all that stuff. First time she's ever been to an American town. She said, is this America? I said, yes, it's America. Isn't she fantastic?
All right, it seems you would like one more tiny piece. We have exactly the thing for you. It's actually a request from Paul. So if you don't like it, go to Paul, please. Fiona and I are here for this Django in June festival. There are concerts on Friday and Saturday. Fiona's on Friday night.
I'm on Saturday night.
With some guitarist, I don't know. Okay, so anyway, going to be great fun as usual. Who am I playing with again? Serge Kiev from France. Through Morocco, I think. Algeria, he's of Algerian descent. And Fiona's playing with accordionist called Marcel Le Flair. Sort of French-German. Is he from Alsace or Lorraine or something? With a name like that? You don't know. He's from your country.
It's a big country.
Yeah, make fun of Holland again. That's great. All right, here we go. Thank you.
Hello.